Hey, what's up everybody? It's Dallas with Gadget Hacks, and today I'm going to show you how to enable fingerprint authentication for root apps. Now this is a pretty simple how-to, so the bulk of this video will be explaining what this does and why you might want to enable it. You will need to be rooted using Magisk to try this, but aside from that, just open your Magisk Manager app. From there, head to the side navigation menu and select Settings. Once inside, scroll down to the bottom and turn on the switch next to Enable Fingerprint Authentication, then scan your fingerprint. Now, if this option is grayed out, that's probably because you don't have fingerprint authentication set up for your phone's main lock screen. You can do that from the security menu inside your Settings app, but of course, that means your phone will actually need to have a fingerprint scanner. At any rate, now you're all set. So let's get into the what and the why. First, what this does is make it to where you'll have to scan your fingerprint anytime you want to give root access to an app. Instead of just tapping grant on that little pop-up that appears when a root app is run for the first time, you'll now have to scan your fingerprint. So why should you enable this? Well, there are a couple of reasons. First, if anybody ever gets into your phone, let's say the authorities, you don't want them to be able to install a root app and use it to pull all sorts of sensitive data off your phone. But secondly, it's also an anti-malware measure. Another app on your phone, especially since you're a rooted user, could theoretically install a malware app, run it, then press grant on that old style root access request. Then with root, the malware app could potentially see your passwords, install a keylogger, or even pull a ransomware move and lock you out of your own phone. But none of that is possible anymore. If anyone or anything wants to give root access to an app, they'll have to scan your fingerprint before that can happen. But for more tips and tricks like this, head on over to gadgethacks.com. And as always, we'd appreciate it if you would like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel. So we'll see you again next time, folks. But until then, happy gadget hacking.